All right, so Vivian tapped on the wall and made a hole in the drywall, and so we're just going to show you guys how to fix this. It's pretty simple, it just takes a little bit of patience. So right now she's screwing in the backing and measuring for the hole, and she's going to put some new drywall in. And if your patch is a little bit smaller than this, you can put a what they call a California patch in. It's just a patch that kind of eliminates the need for tape. But for now, we're just going to put some backing in and cut it to size. And so right here, you want to make sure your screws are in. Okay, you see that bottom screw? It's not all the way in. A lot of homeowners do not put their screws in all the way. And so it's just a matter of making sure they're not all the way through the drywall, but that they're sunk in just a little bit, not breaking the paper.
Pretty messed up, babe. I didn't keep my straight edge straight. Why are you filming still? I'm telling you, I have a problem.
Okay, so Vivian has actually never taped before. I'm just walking her through it, but she's being a good sport about it. So right now she's pre-filling. Okay, she's making a nice flat level surface and filling in all the gaps there, because if we have air behind our tape, we're going to get blisters. So same thing with applying the mud for the tape. You want to make sure that that's nice and flat and you don't have any voids, because otherwise you're going to get blisters as well. Okay, you can overlap the tape because we're going to skim it out enough that it's going to build out enough, so we're not going to see that hump. Okay, so for mud, for your taping, you want to use taping mud. It just has a little bit more glue in and it's going to hold the tape in place and not going to fall off. If you use finishing mud, which a lot of people do and make a mistake of, or even all-purpose is supposed to be able to be used for taping, but it just doesn't have enough glue. So I like to use taping mud. And a box of this stuff here is about $30, just under $30, and it goes quite a ways. So buy a box of taping mud and a box of finished mud, and you can coat lots of stuff in your house. All right, so this is an old box of mud that I'm using. That's why I cut the top off. I don't always mix a full box of mud, and so that just ensures that the dried chunks in the top of the bag don't get into my mud, because that's going to get lines in your mix. Okay, so no matter what mud you want to use, you want to mix it with water. It's just going to do yourself a world of good for your arm to just mix it with water. It's going to be a whole lot easier to work with. You're not going to have to worry too much about shrinkage. And the consistency, there's no set rule here, but the consistency I like to think of for my fill coat and finish coat is kind of the consistency of a frosty. So I like to go do that and just add a little bit of water at a time until you get that consistency. And I'm just using a regular drill here because my mixer is at another job right now. So just a regular drill, and you can mix half a bucket of mud with that. And so just a little bit more water. So yeah, some people like to just take it right out of the box or the bucket and just slap it right on the wall, and they don't know that you're supposed to mix it, and they just get scared because they're not sure how to mix it. They don't know the ratio, and like, there's literally no ratio. I'm just mixing until I get the consistency that I want to work with. Okay, so like taping mud, you want your taping mud pretty runny. And your fill coat, you don't want to add too much water because it'll shrink on you, and you want to keep that bevel or butt joint or patch nice and full. And then your skim coat can be a little bit thinner. So another thing you want to do is, after done mixing your mud, take a knife and clean your bucket down to the mud line. This will make sure that anything on the bucket there doesn't dry and get into your mud. And then another thing you want to do is make sure your tools are nice and clean. Again, you don't want any dry chunks going into your mud, because that'll cause lines in your work. Okay, so now she's just scraping this work area, making sure it's all clean, and mud's going to go on nicely. And then she's using a 12-inch trowel. That's what I like to use for these kind of jobs. And you just want to feather out the about 12 inches on either side of the patch here. And we're just going to go straight across it in probably about 3 passes, okay? So you can either do a forehand stroke like she's doing, or you can do a backhand stroke. It's all a matter of the angle you're working at and what you're more comfortable with, all right? So she's just feathering this out. And again, this is the first time she's doing it. She practiced once. And so she's doing pretty great for the first time doing this. She's being a good sport about it. And so you can start, if you don't want that glob of mud there, you can start your mud higher up on the trowel or angle your trowel a little bit upwards against the wall. See, she's got a line in there. So that's a dried piece of mud that's in her work, and she's got to smooth that over again. All right. And so there is a technique to this, and I'm actually going to show you the technique on the finish coat, because unfortunately she didn't do the finish coat on this one. But yeah, another line there. That's all right. Probably some chunkies in the mud. I call them chunkies. I don't know what else people call them. Okay, so remember how I was telling you we could get blisters in our tape? Well, we got one. Down below in a second here, we're going to show you a big blister, and that's because there is a bit of a void behind our tape in the mud application right there. So let's show you how to fix that.
Got all these blisters here, so you can tap on a drywall and you can hear hollow sounds. So this one here, and if you have a lot of them, you kind of need to start over. But we just kind of have this one spot here. So we're going to cut it out. Need a sharp X-Acto knife. And we're just going to cut out the loose part.
Okay, so let's talk about why that tape bubbled on our patch. Okay, so tape bubbles when the mud behind it, there's not enough of it, or the mud behind it is uneven. Okay, so we're going to put mud on our seam here. Okay, we want nice even coverage. Okay, a little bit thin here still. Okay, nice even coverage. And then we're gonna put our piece of tape on. Again, you wanna make sure that this is the crease side, this is the top, okay? So the crease side goes against the wall, okay? Place it on, and then you're gonna hold one end and start in the middle. Wipe it, clean your knife, then go to the other end. You shouldn't need to hold it because this side's already embedded. I'm gonna wipe it, okay? You don't wanna push too hard in that you wipe all your mud out from behind the tape, because that's also gonna cause a bubble. You're gonna not have enough. You wanna leave enough in there, okay? We're not trying to make it completely flush with the wall. It's gonna stick out a little bit, okay? And the other way, so if I put mud on, I'm gonna put tape on that. Okay, and I have big voids like that. Okay, now I put our tape on that, thinking it's good, and we're just going to wipe it. Okay, put that on and wipe it. Cleaner knife. Okay. We might look at that and say it's good, but as this mud dries and the moisture sucks in, it's gonna leave those bubbles. Okay, so you might be asking, okay, so what's wrong with mesh tape? Why are we using paper tape when we have that chance of it bubbling on us and having to fix it later? And the answer is paper tape is much stronger than mesh tape, okay? So we have a piece of mesh tape here, and if I pull on it this way, it's very strong, okay? Just as strong as paper tape. But if I pull on it this way, okay, it's not very strong at all, okay? So if our joint shifts a little bit like this, then that's gonna crack, and we're gonna see that crack right away. Okay, so we have a little bit of fisheye here. This is just air bubbles. When you coat over an existing paint job, then you're gonna get these air bubbles because the moisture has nowhere to go but out. So you can sand them, but then they fill in with dust. So I just like to scrape them off.
and that way they're not going to fill in with dust as much, and the next coat's going to cover them. Okay, if you get them when you're applying the mud, you can just you take the mud off and you put it back on again, and you keep doing that until you don't get them anymore. Okay, so we're just going to coat this whole thing again, and we are a little bit built up than we want. Okay, and you want to make sure that when you're scraping things off, you don't scrape it into your mud. Okay, so now I have a 12 inch trowel, and you want a fairly decent trowel. This is a Nyla Premium trowel, 12 inch trowel, and they're a lot more comfortable, and the edges are crisper, and they hold mud better. Okay, now to coat this, we could use a 12 inch trowel. I also have a 14 inch Nyla Premium trowel, and so this is kind of a skimming blade. It holds less mud, but you can skim it better. And so, because you might not have both, I'll show you how I do it with just a 12 inch. My bad mud is probably gonna fall off. Okay, so we're gonna skim it bigger, put the mud on. And as you can see, we got tons of bubbles happening here. Lots of bubbles. Okay, so we're just going to scrape it off. And you're just going to get these every time you put over new paint. Okay, I'm going to scrape it off. Probably going to happen again. Okay. We're coating even bigger than our patch now. Don't want to limit ourselves just to the patch, because we want to feather it out and make it unnoticeable, right? So it doesn't matter. You got to repaint this wall anyway. So it doesn't matter if you repaint, 1 foot section or a 4 foot section, 3 foot section, whatever. It's going to look a lot better if you feather it out, okay? Okay, so we got less. That's still going, okay. So I'm gonna coat this. Let them show up.
Take my pajamas?
So we have less bubbles happening.
Your pajamas. Good night.
Good night.
Okay, so I'm gonna scrape it off again. Keeping my trowel angled up so I don't lose all the mud. Okay. And if we do this next coat, then we're gonna get pretty smooth. Okay. Let's see how it goes. Okay. A little bit happening there. Yeah, I'm getting some bubbles there. So, again, I'm going to take it off one more time. Mud. Okay, again, doesn't matter how it goes on, really. It's all about how you take it off, so just want to get us good coverage. Okay, I'm not worried about how big my patch is. I'm going to paint the whole wall anyway. Want to make sure we don't see this. Okay, Okay, so what we're going to do, I'm going to start at the top again, feather the edge. Okay, wipe it off. Start at the bottom, feather the edge. Okay. And now we're going to, so my trowel is not going to cover this next pass all in one. So I'm going to put a little bit of pressure on the top of the blade here. Okay, I got a void there. A little bit of pressure there. Okay, I got lines. I'm going to go to another finish pass here. Feather. Got a lift off. Feather. Okay, so this is the areas we cut out. We're going to have to touch those up again later. Right? So, another finish pass. And one more here, just lightly down the middle. Okay, so you can see we got a lift off here. We have a lift off there. And we got a lift off here. We do have a slight line there. So we're going to let that dry. And we'll probably have to touch it up a little bit here where we cut out the tape. But after that, we'll check it with the big trowel, see how it is, and might be good. Okay, so our second coat is dry, and we're going to do a final skim coat, as well as fill in these tape bubbles that we cut out yesterday. And apparently we have a hard time not touching this wall when we walk down the stairs, because there's a fingerprint there, there's fingerprints there, and there's a couple scratches there. And so I guess we just touch this wall a lot when we go downstairs, which is fine, right? So we just want to scrape down a few of our high spots. Okay. Again, make sure you're holding your mud away from your scraping, because you don't want your dust in your new mud. And this coat isn't going to be much, right? This is just meant to be a finished coat, but we do want to level this out a little bit, because it's still high in the middle. It's good there, and it's good there. And I'm just holding my straight edge to the wall and looking for light gaps. Right, and that's how I'm making sure it's level. All right, so I got my 14 inch skim blade here, and so I want to make sure that I'm not putting a lot of mud on the center here. So once I put it on, I might go up, just to avoid putting too much mud in the middle there. Okay, so the nicer we get this coat, then the easier our sanding will be. Might need more mud. Now the one thing I've noticed with this yesterday, with this blade, is that with how uneven this wall is, it's digging in a few spots. Okay, so it's a little bit harder to control a longer blade, especially on an uneven wall. I'm going to take a little bit off, okay? So I'm feathering that edge, and then as I go down, I'm actually putting pressure slightly on the bottom edge so that my line moves down until my line is completely at the bottom, and then I'm going to wipe that line off, all right? Now hopefully, okay, again, dug in too much there, so I'm going to go back up to the top, get that line. I got a void in the middle there. Okay. Yeah, I'm getting a few more lines with this blade than my skim blade. Oh. It's really uneven here. I might just leave this. See what I can do. Yeah, it's not filling that in very well. The reason this is happening is this wall, there's a big void here. So we built up the tape here. There's a high spot, low spot, and then actually the wall goes high over here again. And I couldn't move those pictures, but I'm going to try to do without. Also, if you see something that needs to be filled in or smoothed over, then don't start on your mud. Start over here on the finished wall and then move into it. And then lift off as you pass off. That's going to cause that lift off. Okay. There. So there's my lift off is right there. That's easily sanded out. Okay, so we're ready for sand here. And we got a little bit of fisheye happening, but it's very small, so we'll be able to scrape that out. And we're going to do a full sand, and then we'll do a light check and a final sand. And should be pretty good. Already feels level. Some high ridges to sand out. But other than that, we'll get going. And nobody wants to watch someone sand, so this will definitely be time-lapsed.
So with pole sanding, you're just trying to knock down the main ridges and make the final sand and light check a little easier. Make sure you're not sanding down to the tape because then you got to refill and resand. And your last step is a light check with the fine side of a sanding sponge. And you're basically just using the light and trying to create as bad of a shadow as you can and sanding out what shows up.
Okay, so we got a close-up here of the work, and a lot of our light's going to come from straight up top, so I want to just shine the light and see what's going to happen. So you can see we got a few lines, and those will actually be filled in with primer. It fills in better with roll-on primer, but you get those quite a bit, especially with my sanding blocks a little bit newer. And this is probably 500 or 600 lumens shining on it. So those will fill in. If you get really close somewhere. Oh, no, I think they sanded out actually. But when I was sanding, I could see the pinholes. But again, they could be filled in. But they were so minuscule that once I primer it and paint it, they might even just fill in. But if I primer it and they show up, then I'll just touch them up and then reprimer it. So if I shine the light over there, okay, we actually have a little line right there that I missed. Got to stand. I didn't see that angle. I can't feel it. But oh no, that's just it's just my fingers wiped it off. That's just a dust line. Okay. All right, so it looks pretty good.